In this video, I'll focus on a selection tool that is used to select elements in one object based on their spatial relation to objects in another feature class. So if we look at in QGIS, we have our, from our natural earth dataset, we have a region that I filtered down to only have Europe. And we also have from the natural earth dataset have the countries of the world. If I now want to select all of the countries that are within this European boundary, I'll need a tool that is not available from up here. So basically, most of the tools in QGIS are available from this processing menu. And in processing menu, you can choose toolbox. And that will give us a series of toolboxes with different tools. Some are for external programs like GRASS, which is Raster GIS, and Sega, and GDAL. And some of them are just groups of internal QGIS tools. In our case, we want to go down to this vector selection part here. And here we can see there is a tool called Select by Location. If you don't know where a tool is, you can also just go up to the search and start typing any word from the title or its help text. But I say location. It points out that there are all of these tools. See, some of these have word location in the help text. In this case, I wanted this Select by Location tool. And the way the tool functions is that you specify the layer in which you want to do your selection. So in my case, I want to select countries. That, then I specify the relation to another layer. So the typical one is intersect. That means that it's within or touches. So basically has anything to do with it. And then I'll choose my region. So anything that is partly within my region will be selected. So I can say run. And you can see that all of these countries are selected. You see, of course, that for Russia is a very large country and only part of Russia is in Europe. And there's also other countries that are only just about touches Europe. If I want to say that the country has to be completely within, I can go to my tool again. And this time, instead of using intersect, I'll use R within. And I can then run my tool. And in this case, only those countries that are completely within are selected. Okay, some of the countries, as a normal, they have large areas outside the European country region. But let's say, why is it that Germany was not selected? So if we try and zoom in, just up here in this little corner, and make sure that our countries is selected. You can see there are two small islands out here that are actually outside the boundary of Europe in this data set. And if I select those two islands, you can see that they are part of the whole of Germany. So that's because those two islands are outside. If I do AR within, then Germany is not within. So be a bit cautious about which aspect you use in this in these different elements. You can also, if you want to select the other way, you can have a smaller object, for instance Denmark, and then you can select those regions that contain the smaller, so that will select Europe, for instance, in this case. So they work, you can both use the larger object to select smaller objects that are within it, or you can use a small object and then select that or those larger objects that contain that smaller object. So that's why there's both a contain and R within, because you could go both ways. I'll just bring it back to this intersect, so I'll get all of these countries. And before, yeah, let's say what it's saying, I just do that region. And by the way, note that this one is a bit different than the other ones, but it does have a, so I can remove from the selection set, or I can select from in it, so on. I just want to create a new selection set and run this. Good. I have mentioned that you typically use selection sets. If you want to do operations, and then you use filters if you want to add something to the map of a specific color. You can, if you wish, choose to create a layer based on these. So you can make a special element that we'll be using a lot when we start doing analysis, namely temporary layers. So this is what this extract thing does. It does exactly the same as I may make this, get rid of this. So we have, if you have a selection set, you can go down to your vector selector here, and we have a select by expression. Okay. So I have mentioned the select by expression as also in the toolbar. But in here, when I do use it as a tool, I can do something a little bit nifty with it. If I go and say select by expression, I want to select from my countries. I only want those that are selected. And then as an expression, I write a 1. So remember that everything else than 0 is true. So this means that all of those that are already selected in this one, they will be, and then I can decide what I'm going to do with them. My matching elements, I can then, over here, I can write them to a file, or I can just leave it as create a temporary layer. I can also show those that do not match. And again, there I can decide what I want to do with them. Skip the output, create a temporary layer, whatever. So with this setting, I will take all of the objects from this layer that are selected. I run them through the expression 1, which always returns true. This means that all of these objects will be added to a temporary layer. And by doing this, you can see what I have achieved is that I now have a new layer, matching features. We'll call them European countries that intersect the European region. And that's for, the only thing is that you can see here, it has this little indication of a RAM chip indicating that it is in memory. That's of course very important, because if your QGIS crashes, it will disappear. It's not saved to the hard drive anywhere, but it is something you often do for two reasons. One, if you want to make a map that includes the selection set, and the other is if you want to do some quick calculations and you do not want to write it into the hard drive, you might create things at these temporary layers. Temporary layers are really useful, and they function just like the other ones. You can do all the standard things that you can do. So I could say I want to give them categories based on their administrative name. Just to classify, and so it's functioning just like any other layer, but it is just a temporary layer that I created by using the extract by expression, and then taking all the selected features from my countries and passing them through this true expression. So this expression that results in the true. So all of those objects will now be written to a temporal layer. I can also change them. So I can write them to a physical, to a geo database, if that's what I want. And I can also, so if I need the layer to be constant also after a crash or I've closed QGIS, then I can do that. So temporary layers are a variation of somewhere in between a filtered layer. So you can use these temporal layers because the selections are all this yellow, not really interesting to look at. But you can, if you use these extract by expression, this little trick here, you can create your selection set as a layer that you can do coloring on, and you can start doing new selections and so on. So this temporal layer is some in between the filter and the selection set, and it's something you should use often. And also think about that this select by location, that it is a really sensitive to small islands or whatever in your selection. And again, maybe this region of Europe could use a bit of a cleanup, because it is a bit silly that Germany is not part just because of those two islands. So be always critical about your data set. It's not necessarily that it's just because there's some data that says this is the region of Europe. It doesn't necessarily have to be completely true. So that was all for this time.